Today we're going to journey to the dark side. Rather than the usual dark text and images on a light background, we'll do just the opposite. We'll work with light-colored pens and ink pads on dark backgrounds. This is different from the usual way I work, but I really like it because I think it adds interest to my art. Let's get started, and I'll show you how. When I work on dark surfaces, I tend to do one of a few things. I might stamp with a light color pigment pad, like this. I might work with Perfect Pearls, a lighter version of Perfect Pearls, because they're going to reflect and they're going to show on the dark surface. Or if I want to write, I'm going to choose something like a light color gel pen or these really great sparkle pens that that Sakura make in the Jelly Roll line. So we're going to start, let me clear all this off. We're going to start by stamping with some pigment ink. And the reason that we're going to use pigment ink is because it's opaque, and that means that the dark color is not going to show quite so much through it, and it will result in a lighter image when we stamp. And obviously we're going to work with a light color because that's going to show up on our dark surface. Now, the Adirondack pigment pads all come with these little plastic liners, and I always leave them on, and Ranger advises that you do. It helps stop the pads from drying out. So I'm going to take, and this I believe is Shell Pink in the pigment line. I'm going to ink up my stamp, put this to one side, and then I'm just going to stamp. Now again, the reason that this is going to work is because A, I'm using a light color ink, but also because I'm using a pigment ink, which is opaque. And so you see, you can take virtually any stamp, and as long as you use the right kind of ink pad, you can go ahead and stamp on your dark surfaces and get a great impression. Another way that you can add light designs to a dark card is by using Perfect Pearls. And if you don't remember or you haven't seen me create backgrounds on tags like this, there'll be a segment at the end of this video that shows you how I do it. So I'm going to work with Ranger's Perfect Medium, and I have this really cool roller that Inka Dinka Doo makes. And I'm just going to roll this on the Perfect Medium pad until I know that the whole roller is well covered with the Perfect Medium, because the Perfect Medium is what's going to adhere the Perfect Pearls powder to this tag. And I'm just going to, I think I'll do it this way, I'm just going to roll from one end to the other. Now obviously as I get toward the other end of this card, or this tag rather, the Perfect Medium will have started to roll off of the roller, which means that there's more up here and less up here, which probably means that I'm going to see less adhesion of the Perfect Pearls, but we'll play and see how that looks. I'm going to use some turquoise Perfect Pearls, and then I'm going to use some Perfect Bronze. And I'm just going to pounce this onto the area where I rolled. Let me start picking up some of this copper now, or this bronze rather. I can kind of blend the colors in. And you get this really cool effect. And one of the things that I really like is layers. I think that it adds a really nice look to everything. It stops pieces from looking flat and one-dimensional. And this is a great way to add layers. All right. With all of this pounce, I'm just going to knock this out. I'm just going to come in and brush the excess off. And you can see the pattern on here and how cool this is. Now this brush is not real clean, so I'm going to take one of my rags here and I'm just going to wipe the excess powder off. And I have this really big brush that works far better than the other one was. And now you can see this really great design on here. And because this is Perfect Pearls, not only do you get the effect of the color, but you get the effect of the shimmer, which many of you who know me know that I love something that shimmers. So again, when you're working on a dark surface, working with Perfect Pearls and this roller or any kind of a rubber stamp is a great way to get some design and some texture onto your piece. I like to use gesso with stencils, and you can use it straight as it comes from the jar, stark white, or you can do what I'm going to, which is to take a little bit, and this is some of my diluted color wash, a little bit of color wash, and mix it into the gesso. Now, I'm using a fair amount because this was so dilute when I mixed the color wash with water that it's not going to make a huge difference in the color if I don't add enough. So this is becoming just slightly kind of pink magenta, and I'm going to mix this up, and then I'm going to grab my stencil and this tag that I was working on, and I'm just going to scrape this through the openings. And I'm going to do this kind of randomly. I'm not really concerned about getting every last opening done. It doesn't have to be perfect. This is just an opportunity to add some texture to this tag. And then I'm just going to come back and scrape all across the top so I know I don't have any excess in there. Pick up my stencil. And how cool is that? Not only do I get huge contrast, but my contrast is slightly pink. Stencils and gesso are just a perfect match and something that I use quite often when I'm working on tags or pages, and I know you're going to have fun with them too. When it comes time to write or draw on your dark surface, your normal options like a Pitt or a Pigma pen aren't going to work because the black ink is simply not going to contrast with the background enough. You can use a plain white Jelly Roll pen, which is something that I do quite often. Sakura make what they call silver sparkle pens, or just sparkle pens that are glitter pens. They make metallic pens. There's all kinds of things, but ultimately what you need is something with an ink that's opaque and will contrast with the tag, or your background rather. And you can see that I've written here with this pen. This happens to be one of their metallic pens. Now, it's good for writing, and I've written a quote from Einstein here that kind of goes with our winged timepiece. And you can work on your borders too if you want to add a little bit of interest around the edge. Let me grab my pen here. There's all kinds of things that you can do that make working on a dark surface not as difficult as you would think. And the metallic pens, the Jelly Roll pens, the Stardust pens are all great options for doing that. One workaround for dark surfaces is that rather than applying your design directly to the surface, in this case this tag, you can create elements separately and then apply them to the surface. And then you're not limited to using light colored inks or the other kinds of things that we've discussed. What I did was I used the same stamp that you saw me use earlier. This is the Inka Dinka Doos. It's a winged timepiece. I forget exactly what it's called. But I stamped this on a plain tag with some stays-on ink, and then I came in and I spritzed some color wash on it and some Perfect Pearls mists and cut the wings out. These steampunk hearts from Jolie's Boutique are adhesive on the back. And once I had my wings cut out, I stuck them on the back, I lined them up of this on the back of the heart, and then I attached this whole piece to the tag. I've used some of my metallic gel pens from Sakura to create this little border right here. Along at the top, I used Perfect Medium and the other roller that comes with the set that you saw me use earlier that was florals. This one's just circles within circles. I rolled it perfect medium along the top here. I put my Perfect Pearls on, and I'll take a still photo of this so you can see it really well. These are steampunk gears, also by Jolie's Boutique. And then the last thing I'm going to do is I have a sentiment that I stamped on another tag. I misted with Perfect Pearls, and then I spritzed with some color wash. And this is from one of the dilution sets, and the sentiment fits sort of with the overall theme of this. So I will just go ahead and glue this in place. So whether you use light colored pigment ink, whether you use light colored pens, or any of the things that we've talked about today, there's plenty of ways that you can work with dark colored surfaces and sort of expand your repertoire. I hope you have as much fun working with them as I did. You've seen me do this before, but if you need a refresher, I'm going to just do this quickly so that you can get some sense of how I add color to tags. You can either work with a dry tag or a wet tag, and I'm going to mist this just a little bit so I get kind of a watercolor effect. And then I'm just going to randomly come in and I'm going to spritz color on here. And I'm going to dry this. When I do this, I like to work in layers, and that's oftentimes how I end up with a really dark surface to work on, and that's actually how I accidentally got started working on all of these dark surfaces, because I kept playing and adding color, and the next thing I knew, I had a really dark surface that I couldn't actually use a dark colored pen on. Now you're going to see me do this several times. I'm going to come in and I'm going to spritz, and then I'm going to dry, and I'm going to spritz, and I'm going to dry, and that's how I end up with these multiple layers and this depth of color. One of the ways that I like to get kind of a blotchy effect is to take this and turn it over, and you'll see that there's mists of these colors that sort of fell outside of the card. And so I'll pick this up, and you can see what starts to happen here. You get these kind of colors that layer one on top of the other. And I'll just keep doing this until I end up with a really dark surface. Or if I like this the way it is, then I obviously wouldn't mess with it. I would just go ahead and use it. But as I said, this is how I end up with these really dark surfaces. Like this, and like this, and these are a little bent. So let me just straighten them out so you can see. And these are the ones that you saw me work on earlier in the video. So if you like your dark surfaces, this is a great way to go ahead and get them.